Okay, Willie. Well, it's your last minute father here. So I got a little job for you. We got these special 30-year people, been here 30 years. There's seven of them. What I'd like to have you do is get them each on an interview. Most of them are old fuddy-duddies. Bonnie's one of them, so we might have to give her a glass of wine before we can get her open up a little bit. So I just sent out a company-wide email telling everybody that you're going to interview everybody. But we're going to disguise this as we're doing for everybody, but we're going to honor these seven people. It doesn't happen very often that worked here 30 years this past year. Mm-hmm. That's like, wow. It's a pretty big honor. Not many companies have seven of them make it. That's your job for the next couple days. Your last minute dad is at it again, trying to plan something for company dinner.
Sounds good.
Okay. So you look pretty.
Pretty. I don't need a pretty look. Yeah. Can I have a beer? But hey, can you give me a beer? I'll be able to talk a little freer there.
I gotta sit up straight. Are my glasses good?
Leave.
Our Indian name for him is Wind in His Hair. I had way longer hair than you do.
It's a nice man purse you're carrying there, too.
Two of them. Which one do I look at?
You can look at me.
Mike likes my legs.
We'll see.
You gotta remember, we grew up in the 70s.
Yeah, that's good. I think so.
Make sure you got the R pointed out. There you go.
I'm hard working at work. Oh, yes. Here comes Craig now. Shit.
Am I talking in here?
This is an awful lot of work.
Why would they do that to me? I'm gonna hide it. Crazy buggers. I wonder why we don't get nothing done.
Alrighty. What's your name?
My name is Rod Hofaker.
Craig Wynn.
You don't know my name?
Yes.
Bonnie DeBrian.
My name is Dan Kuiper.
Brent Postma.
I'm Dale Terwisha, and I'm a salesman here. Try to be.
Ken Kleindell, Butch, from my mom. I had a flat top with Butch wax in my hair, so he always called me Butch.
Job description, that's kind of tough, but shop foreman is the official title.
Warranty writer, whole goods inventory control, among other things.
Fixing corn heads, grass heads and that, yeah, fixing stuff.
Parts manager, IT professional, maintenance guy.
I part sales. I work mostly with like Kloss and JCB.
My job description, I don't have one anymore.
Don't really have a job description. It's kind of just what you fall into. Nobody really does. It's just kind of everybody just does their work. You have to pull your own weight, get the work done.
I worked for Duane for 30 years and I was here for 6 years prior to that. I worked for Keels Incorporated, started with them in 1982 and then started with Duane in November of 88 when he took over.
Probably 33 years?
35 years.
Since they moved to Linden in, what was that, 1986, 7?
Right around 30 years, I think. Right at the beginning when they moved from Clearbrook to here. Yes, I'm 37, yeah. I started young. Didn't have child labor laws back then.
30 years, at least, yeah.
In February of 88. Worked here 31 years. I remember there again the first day I got hired, I wanted to bring up that I got $6 an hour. I don't know what minimum wage back then, but that's what Duane started me at, is $6 an hour. But Willie, when you were working here, I know you were quite young. You only got $3 an hour.
I thought it was going to be my last day, too. I was cleaning up a two-row John Deere corn head. I oiled the chains right on the concrete slab in front of the shop instead of doing it out on the gravel somewhere. That was a big mistake.
My first job at Skolten's Equipment was a long-haul truck driver. My first day was to take the old Eagle and take it on a road trip just quickly up the guide to Hawksburg and Hay and then back. I remember that quite vividly because I didn't know what Duane was going to think about my driving style.
I did a PTO clutch adjustment on an old Case 830. That was my first job for Duane. For Keels, I was pressure washing and working on Gale forage wagons. Don't miss that stuff, no. He gathered all of his people that he brought from Sumas and the Keels people here down in the shop, just gave us all a really big pep talk, and it was pretty uplifting.
Not really, because I was anticipating it. I had a feeling Duane had already discussed it with him and I, and I knew it was coming down. I just didn't know for sure if it was going to happen. So it was really exciting for me, yeah.
Yes, I came from the Clearbrook Road. My sister Patty worked with Dwayne. I didn't even meet Dwayne starting out. Patty just brought me into the job, and then I had to meet the boss. But he said, no, I could stay. So I must have been okay, right? Dad let me stay?
Good decision.
Yeah, good decision.
I was still doing silent loaders then, too, but yeah, I still remember it, roughly. It's been a while. We're up in the Pat's room up there, and then in the green shed out here that used to be out here where the new building is. We had to dig our way in through the snow drifts, me and Mark. Yeah, there was no heat in there, no.
Probably inventory control.
Well, my favorite part of my job is irritating Dwayne, your dad.
The fact that I get to deal with people every day, and I kind of like people, like talking to people, and I enjoy what I'm doing, like helping people out.
The employees, the guys in the shop are a lot of fun. We have a good time together.
The people I work with, and mostly farmers and stuff, I've known farmers all my life, so. Used to do silo loaders, and there was a lot of them in the county at one time. Used to do 2-3 a day.
Probably the flexibility and being able to meet a lot of nice people, but on the other side of that, there's people that weren't always so pleasant either. I remember the best ones, the good ones, and there were a lot of them.
Really love helping people with their maintenance items when they come in and ask questions about their new little tractor and helping them out with that and carrying stuff out to their car and just getting a chance to get to know them a little bit, you know, because we don't meet them as parts people. We don't meet them at the onset. The salesmen do, but that first sell of service parts is usually pretty fun. Well, about being old and the fact that I don't hear as well as I used to, people have to repeat stuff.
My customers, maybe.
Nobody dares.
Not really. I keep my mouth shut, so.
They call me the sheriff because I don't like messes around the shop.
AKA friend of farmer, I guess. Probably not wear it when I don't wear my hat. How's that? Other than that, they leave me alone.
They don't tease me much.
Dragged the ramps behind the old trailer when I drove semi back 20 some years ago. We had a beaver tail trailer and you had ramps you had to set on the back of it. And then when you're done loading, you took them, put them up on the bed and strapped them down. And I failed to do the last part. And so I started to head out of the driveway with the ramps dragging. So I get teased about that one quite often still, especially by Henry.
Gosh, I haven't done anything embarrassing.
Drove a Kloss chopper back from the fairgrounds after one of our chopper clinics, and I had the spout up in the air, and I caught a power line going across Front Street.
I had a guy that wanted some information on that old New Holland that we had out back, and I jumped in the cab, was taking pictures, and I couldn't get the doors to open. The latches didn't work. I had to call Craig, and he sent a guy out there to unlatch me, and I think Dwayne wished he would have just told me to sit out there for an hour or two before they released me. It was kind of embarrassing to get locked in a cab out there.
When I just hit the rake out there with my Cadillac, well, they parked that 25-foot Kubota rake behind my Cadillac, and I tried to turn to miss it and hit it instead.
Yeah, I had a mixer box out on the wash slab. I unhooked from it from the boot on the forklift. I dropped the boot down, and then all of a sudden the mixer box started rolling down the wash slab, and there was a curb sitting there, and then the tire hit the curb and knocked the fence over. Otherwise, it would have went out in the trailer court there and hit a trailer, so that was pretty embarrassing. They had it on film, so yeah. Me chasing it with the forklift and the boot trying to get it.
Took me a while to live down the power line incident, but other than that.
Oh, probably when I sold the customer who was going up into Canada to work on his machine, I sold him the correct filters to service his machine out, and he had it all taken apart, but I had pulled the wrong ones. And he had to drive back down from Canada to get them for me. He wasn't too happy.
Oh, I remember I jumped on a tractor one time and I drugged the stupid jump cart out to jump it because the thing wouldn't start. And then I noticed that the PTO was engaged on a Kubota. And disengage a Kubota, then it starts up. So that was kind of embarrassing, yeah.
No, I fix things.
No,
I don't
okay.
Break things. I fix. Oh.
A lot of things, yeah.
Not that I can think of.
Changing the lights and dropped a bunch of fluorescent tubes one day in the showroom here. That was a huge mess.
Oh, I am the first person, maybe the second, Dwayne might have been the first, but I ran into the big post on the north end of on the north door of the new building, which was our pride and joy at that time. I hit it with a forklift and I hit it really hard and I cracked it. So I had to go out there and repair that. That's the only thing I really broke big time here.
Why not? I know it would have just been something small on a project, you know, nothing big that I can think of. So I don't think I won the major tailgate award yet.
I still think of the day I made Jim Fleece walk in the field when he didn't think something was warrantable and just left him out in the field. That was a good day.
I don't know, I got a big hug from Steve one day. Full body, full upper body hug, yeah.
My best moments were probably back in the days when I was trucking and I used to run all over the place. It was kind of like being on paid vacation where Dwayne was paying the bill and I was enjoying it.
We laugh in the office all the time, so we have a lot of funny stories. A lot of stories I have a memory of, but a lot of them I can't repeat.
I had a guy one day ask me how many square inches there were inside of a tire.
Just happened this year. I sold that old McCormick I traded in for Vanderhawks, and I think it sat out there for 8 years. Every time I'd drive around the lot, I'd see that old tractor, and it just made me so happy when it finally went away. Didn't make any money on it, but it's gone, so yeah.
The one something that happened just recently is kind of funny is Phyllis walked through the fresh concrete after it got fixed upstairs. That was pretty funny. We had a pretty good laugh about that.
A couple times I irritated your dad. It's a long story, but I went in there when Dad had a customer and I said he needed to take a phone call when he really didn't. I should have took a message. And Dad looked at me with that look, and it's kind of like, oh my goodness, I could be on my way out.
No, not really. I don't think so. I did get in a bit of trouble back in my trucking days. I was a lot younger then, and Dwayne used to get fairly upset with me about some of my off-duty practices. But other than that, no, I don't think, I never really felt like I was going to get fired.
There's probably been times, but I, to be honest with you, I can't think of what they'd be right now.
No, I don't think so. Might have pushed the envelope, but I don't think I was going to get fired.
I worry about it every day. I thought I'd do something stupid, you know. I still feel it's kind of weird that I get trusted with somebody else's money. You know, there's a lot at stake. Bad trade-in, quote the wrong price. It's got that in the back of my mind on just about every deal. Just, is this going to be okay? Cheat sheets. That's the nicest thing to have a cheat sheet, so.
Probably working on the old 5000 series John Deere choppers back in the 1980s.
Boda.
Boda, there you go.
Yeah, we all love Boda.
I enjoy coming to work here. It's a great group of guys. It's a great job. I keep telling people I've got the best job in Linden.
I like every day. Just everything. I enjoy every day, every next day, every summer.
I always liked working here. I've had a fun job. I mean, a fun time 31 years working at Skolten's Equipment. I probably did most of the picking on the girls like Phyllis and Audrey and Tana and Dad. Always Dad. Get that look, you know. You know you have to get your job done and you walk in there and he looks up from his computer and kind of looks like, really? You need to talk to me now?
Oh, just the people I work with. You know, everybody gets along good. Good atmosphere.
The people. Really the people, yeah. That's probably the most fun, is interacting with the guys.
I think the people. I would have a hard time not being able to bullshit people. I like it.
Working every day, and I like working. I don't know what I'd do otherwise, so. And seeing some of the people I work with here for quite a while, so.
I guess the growth that we've seen in the company, you know, to go from what we started with to what we are today.
The flexibility. I don't, you know, if I ever asked Dwayne for a day off, he'd never say no. I don't think. I've never had him say no. So, no, I the flexibility of this job has been pretty good, and that's why I'm surprised that, you know, I'd recommend being a salesman to a lot of people. I just do. I think it's a cool deal. I still don't know what I want to be. So when I grow up, I'll decide. So for now, this is what it is. So.
I think my most important thing I'm going to miss is irritating Dwayne. And I have done a lot of that.
A few years ago, I'd had some positive feedback from a customer about what we do here at Skolten's Equipment. It's not just about the parts department, it's about service and it's about sales. And it's about how we treat people on the phone. And one morning I was getting ready for work and I was looking in my closet for a shirt to wear. And I realized how many pieces of clothing I owned that had my boss's name on it. And it's a lot. I got a lot of shirts, I got jackets, all this stuff. And I thought, wow, that's a lot of clothes with the Skolten Equipment logo on it. And I thought, it would be really cool if the boss's name was Armani or Ralph Lauren. I realized, you know, at that point in time, you know, after hearing good feedback from customers that logo is a badge of honor that we wear, and it's also something that we shouldn't take lightly. You know, we should wear it like a badge of honor. We should always uphold that name, because that's the livelihood that we have, and it's going to be the livelihood of these young guys that are coming up behind us, old guys. We just wear it with pride. When I'm out in public and people say, oh, I see you work for Skolten's Equipment, that's a pretty nice place to work. That sounds like a good outfit. And I said, yeah, it is.
Like I said, it's been a long time, so a lot of good things happened here. So.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome. Appreciate thank you. Yeah. Hi, everybody.
The average tenure for an employee in the U.S. is 4.4 years. Now you realize how big a deal this is. Somebody puts in 30. First, we have special guests here because one of the guys didn't have any family here, and I thought it only appropriate that we fly his kids out here. So I want to ask Ken Kleindel to come forward. Come on in. Come on in. Your hard work, loyalty, dedication has made Skolten's Equipment the success it is. Thank you, Dwayne Skolten. Says the same thing Butch's did, but we did put your name on it instead of his. You special. No. Congratulations, Rob.
Years of irritating Wayne. He used to come and kick my chairs and fire me, and yet I never listened.
We're out that smile, man. Smile.
You have to sweep to the back. You have to go to the front.
And the reason I call them Heaven Zeven, is I think they're a gift from heaven. To put up with me, to stick by me, and to stick with Skolten's Equipment and make it a success.
And don't be the guy that works at Farmer's Equipment, you know?